This week on the Rider Sports Report, we get an inside look at the Mauer Gym, take a look at one of the hottest teams at Rider, and catch up with the intramural team of the week.
All that and more as we take a look at some of the best sports coverage here on campus, only on the Rider Sports Report.
Welcome to the Rider Sports Report. I'm Olivia Hoff.
And I'm Matt Metzger. With the ongoing construction alumni gymnasium, the Mauer Gym has become that much bigger of a resource to our student-athletes here on campus. Our field reporter Tiffany Pukas has the story.
Mauer Gym is the strength and conditioning center in the very back of Rider's campus. It is a place where our student-athletes go to train for their seasons under the watchful eye of Jerry Green, who has been with the program ever since it came about 3 years ago.
Full-time, about 3 years as a strength and conditioning coach and coordinator. We can facilitate, based on the design of the program, I'm able to facilitate large teams, and we're also able to do it in such a way where we can do pretty much the same exercises throughout those different groups. So it's very flexible. It's old school in the sense of that's the way we train with athletics. We don't need the different types of machines, and we do have those for injured athletes. But pretty much, you know, we do a lot of free weights, we do bands, we do plyometric work, so we do a lot of different types of training. We're able to do it all in one facility. Basically, and what I try to get across to the athletes is this is just like a practice. And just in the same, you know, and results are going to come from intensity and from having that serious attitude. And that has to, the same attitude and the same tenacity and the same type of intensity that you have in a practice has to be in this facility too. I think at a Division I program, there's a lot of expectations. You know, I mean, there's expectations on the athletes. There's expectations on me. You know, I mean, I need to show results. You know, so we'll do a lot of testing on some of the programs. So I need to, you know, things that have a high transfer. So for instance, if I have a track and field jumper, you know, we need to make sure that we test his long jump, that we test the vertical jump. There's such a high correlation between speed and maximum squats, and we do a lot of the Olympic lifting for explosiveness. I mean, our field hockey team is undefeated right now, so we're hoping to continue with that. Women's soccer is on the upswing. They're getting some more wins, and we want to finish strong with, men's soccer and volleyball and our winter sports. I mean, we're looking to get to that next level. So they both made the playoffs, and went pretty far in the playoffs, so we want to get to that next level. So looking forward to that.
It looks like it's going to be a good year for Rider athletes, and I'm sure Jerry Green will make sure of that. This has been Tiffany Pukas for the Rider Sports Report.
While we're all fired up here in the set, let's take a look at one of the hottest teams on campus, our very own Lady Bronx field hockey team. This past week, they took on Bryant College as they look to extend their winning streak to 13. Let's see how they did.
The Rider field hockey team keeps trailblazing as they add on another win against Bryant University. The girls held a strong lead throughout the whole game, leaving the final score 3-0.
The big thing is pressure steal. You always gotta, once you're in the circle, you have to think score. But it's a second effort. Like, if you lose the ball, coach is like, all right, that's fine, but come back and get it. And, like, always as a forward, you gotta come back, nip back, keep coming, and everyone just pressures the ball.
Freshman Austin Swartz scored her first goal of the season with less than 2 minutes left before halftime.
Pass from Virginia, and it was a really good experience, but once it all came together, like everyone worked together, when everyone came in to celebrate it, that was the best part. When we all got fired up, that was the adrenaline rush.
Affecting certain plays, such as the circle, made it possible to tackle Bryant's defense.
Yeah, that's a corner. Like, if there's a circle, like the semicircle, we just call it a circle. If you foul inside it, like if it hits your foot, you high stick it, anything like that, it's a corner, so it's like a power play, so like numerical advantage.
The team is remaining undefeated and moving up in their conference.
I think we're one of three teams still undefeated in the nation. So, yeah, we just got to keep working hard.
Expectations for playing other teams are that they can continue to defeat and execute plays.
So we want to bring it to them just as hard, no matter what team it is. We're going to bring our game and hopefully come out on top.
Shaquelle Sutton reporting for Riders Sports Report.
Our field reporter Shaquelle Sutton caught up with Matt Curio about staying active with intramural sports here on campus.
Matthew Curio, the graduate assistant for Campus Life and Recreation Programs, gave us some information on intramural sports.
Most of our participants sign up as a team with their friends or people who live on their floors or people they meet in class. Or you can sign up as an individual as well, and we'll put you on a team, so it's a good way to meet people.
Matthew explained the benefits of intramural sports.
Is, you know, staying active, being an active body is always good for the body, as well as, you know, the social aspect, being out and just having a good time with some friends or just people that you may not know.
Players of the games enjoy and see value of playing.
Having fun, taking people's flags, beating them, getting pride out of that, and just having fun and getting exercise.
It's like a good release to get away from like class and get on the field and play some sports so you can forget about all that stuff for a while.
Issues such as competitiveness bring more edge to the game.
Range from people who have never really played the sports, just having a good time, to pretty high level of competition, people who are really athletic and know what they're doing and really have a desire to win.
A lot of competition with the really talented teams, like the top teams. They all want to win, you know.
Winning amongst the intramural teams bring rewards that players don't mind striving for.
Time you just get a t-shirt and bragging rights, but for our bigger leagues like flag football and basketball, we actually send our champions to extramural tournaments. We've sent them to the University of Maryland to compete against champions from all the other schools in the area, as well as Boston University hosts a tournament similar to that.
Intramural is always planning events and games to look out for.
We have the Madden tournament as well. It's the third year we're running that, and we're going to be giving away Eagles-Cowboys tickets to that for the winner of that.
This is Shaquelle Sutton reporting for Rider Sports Report.
While we're on the subject of football, let's ask Sal B, who you starting?
Thanks, guys. This is Who You Starting, and I'm Sal B. This week, we're doing things a little differently. I'm going to have a little diagram for everybody to see who we're starting and why. This week, on running backs, we're going to start the Jets, Thomas Jones. That's right, TJ, all day. This week, he goes against the Raiders. He's going to do the same thing that he did last week against who other than the Bills. He had 205 rushing yards and a touchdown. This week, I say he's good for 100 yards, and I'm saying about 7 receptions, probably around, let's say, 2 touchdowns, and he's going to have a great game against the Raiders. I know the Raiders did good against the Eagles, but that's the Eagles. They were struggling. McNabb wasn't in his groove. Sanchez is not in his groove either, which is why Thomas Jones will get the ball. Also, if you want to put somebody in your flex, Leon Washington, not a bad decision at all. On to quarterbacks. This week, I'm going to tell you to start Texans' Matt Schaub. That's right, Texans' Matt Schaub. In week 6, he had more than 396 throwing yards. That's right, 396. He had a couple touchdowns. He had 2 interceptions. He had a great day carrying fantasy football teams. 30 points he had. That's how he carried them, with 30 points. He will do the same thing in week 7 when he goes against the 49ers. Guys, the 49ers D is not that good. And you know who proved that? Brett Favre, another quarterback who loves to throw the ball. He did the same thing a couple weeks ago. Schaub, week 7, start him. On to tight ends. I give you Schenko. We're talking about Favre. Let's talk about Schenko. Vasante Schenko, he hooked up with Favre a couple times this week. He had a touchdown when he went against Baltimore. And then this week, week 7, he will go against the Steel City. I'm saying he's good for about a touchdown and maybe 7 to 10 receptions. On to wide receivers. Let's go on to Donald Driver, who seems to be, I'll say it one more time, seems to be the number one receiver over at Green Bay. Jennings has been covered, double covered, leaving Donald Driver open all day. Aaron Rodgers finds him in the end zone. He finds him all around the field. I'm saying Donald Driver is good for at least 10 receptions and most likely a touchdown. That's right, a touchdown, 10 receptions, Donald Driver, stardom. Final thoughts. I have a problem with one team in particular, and that's the Jets. They cannot finish. That is a huge problem. If they can't finish, that means they won't win games. Fantasy-wise, Mark Sanchez, 1.22 points. Thomas Jones, great game. Vion Washington, great game. The Jets defense, good game. I mean, the Bills only got a couple points on you, but nonetheless, you cannot perform that well if you expect to be in the playoffs. You cannot perform that well if you expect to be started on fantasy teams.
That's it for this week's show. To stay up to date with all your Rider sports information, go to www.gobronx.com and tune in next week. This has been Olivia Hoff.
And I'm Matt Metzger. From all of us at the Rider Sports Report, have a great week, Rider.